Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. This is a follow-up, or add-on if you will, to the earlier video How to Configure Fingerprint Scanning in Linux Mint, where the configuration of fingerprint scanning is explained. As mentioned there, configuration differs between the Linux distributions. Some have it built into the graphical user interface, into the users section in the settings, and some don't. For Linux Mint, some configuration is required. For more details, please refer to the earlier video. A link is in the description below for your convenience. Also, the comment section of that video learned us a few things. Some viewers can't get their fingerprint device to work because it is not on fprintd's supported devices list, and that will be a challenge indeed. Some unsupported devices are mentioned on internet posts, and people are repeatedly asking for a Linux, not just Linux Mint, driver for years now. If the manufacturer is not creating a driver, it will be a challenge to get it supported by fprintd. In that case, you might need to look for custom drivers or compile your own kernel with support for the device, but that's clearly not the intention of this video and out of scope. Some do have a supported device and run into problems anyway, and others just sail through it with flying colors and no issues at all. A viewer is having troubles getting his fingerprint enrolled consistently. I really do appreciate this sort of interaction, that's what the channel is about in my mind, so please keep them coming. In this case, it is a swiping fingerprint device, already cleaned with rubbing alcohol, not a joke, that might actually work. Try it a different finger and try it to vary the swiping speed. This video is about placing fprintd in debug mode, so that you can see its every move and look behind the curtains in an attempt to learn why your fingerprint device might not be working. We will also have a look at the system locks. I keep mentioning it, but please make sure your fingerprint device is actually on the supported devices list. Again, a link is in the video description, to at least give yourself a fighting chance. I'm demonstrating this on a Lenovo ThinkPad T16 with Linux Mint with the Cinnamon desktop environment. The point where we start in this video is that our fingerprint device is already recognized by your system. We are now stuck at the fingerprint enroll phase. I'm going to place fprintd in debug mode and then enroll a fingerprint into the system and see what happens. Although you can't adjust the number of scans directly, you can try enrolling the same fingerprint multiple times. For example, after an incomplete enrollment, try enrolling it again immediately, or just enroll it a couple of times anyway. Even if it reads enroll successful, it sometimes isn't saved on the first try. Feeding it multiple fingerprint scans might help the software to learn your fingerprint better. First, list any fingerprints available. fprintd-list and then your username. If any fingerprints are enrolled, let's clean it up to start fresh with the command fprintd-delete username. Now stop fprintd with the command sudo systemctl stop fprintd. Check if fprintd is indeed stopped. Sudo systemctl status fprintd. To my knowledge, there are three different ways to place fprintd in debug mode. I will show them one at a time so you can make a decision what method works best for you. Debug method 1. This is the easiest one, as there is nothing to undo in any configuration file afterwards if you want to stop debugging later. Also, this is a good candidate if you don't want to change any files. Just run sudo env and then in capitals g underscore messages underscore debug equals all forward slash usr forward slash libexec forward slash fprintd. I've noticed that this is the default location on Linux Mint for fprintd, which might be different from other distributions. This will enable interactive debugging, and once done, fprintd won't be in debug mode anymore. Debug method 2. Enable debug logging by modifying the system configuration. We will debug via systemd. This way, debug mode will stay in place until you disable it later. Sudo systemctl edit fprintd. This by default will open the nano editor. If you want to use vi instead, you can use this command. Sudo editor equals vi systemctl edit fprintd. In this case, I will use nano to explain the default behavior. The second line reads, anything between here and the comment below will become the new contents of the file. So we go to the third line with the arrow keys and type open bracket service closing bracket. Hit enter and on the next line type environment equals g underscore messages underscore debug equals all. Pay attention to the capitalization of the text. Now type control plus x and when asked to save, type y and hit enter. Now reload the systemd configuration, type sudo systemctl daemon-reload. Debug method 3 involves directly editing the fprintd service configuration file. You can use any editor, but I will be using vi. Sudo vi lib systemd system fprintd.service. Go to the bottom and add the line environment equals g underscore messages underscore debug equals all. Once again, pay attention to the capitalization of the letters. Again, via this method, debug will stay in place until you disable it at a later time. Now to be sure, reload the systemd configuration. Type sudo systemctl daemon-reload. After selecting and having configured one of the debug methods, start fprintd again. Sudo systemctl start fprintd. And check with sudo systemctl status fprintd. And at the bottom it reports that the fingerprint authentication daemon has started. Now that fprintd is running in debug mode, we can view its logs to see the output. Sudo journalctl -u fprintd-f. The -f option means that we will follow the log in real time. And the -u option means that we only want to follow the unit fprintd. Open a second terminal window and place it next to the first one so we can watch the log in real time while we continue with fprintd. To see if this is working, just an example, list the current fingerprints. There should be none as we cleaned up earlier. Because we are debugging at the all level, all sorts of information will now appear in the left window that reports the debug information back to us. Now try to enroll a fingerprint, fprintd-enroll. Without specifying any options, this will be for the current user and the right index finger. Please see the linked video in the description if you need help with fprintd in general. As my fingerprint reader is working correctly and the enroll will complete successfully, let me try switching fingers in the middle of the enroll to mix it up. This will result in enroll retry scan and enroll unknown error messages and the related debug information you can study on the left hand side. There are more ways to get fprintd information out of the Linux Mint logs. For example, sudo journalctl -u fprintd pipe more. This command will give you all the information for the service fprintd since the start of the systemd journal. If you want to only have the information since your last boot, add the -b option. Sudo journalctl -u fprintd -b pipe more. To watch the system log, type sudo less var log syslog pipe grep fprintd. Play around with or without grep filtering around the timestamps that look interesting to you. To print kernel ring buffer information, simply type DMESG. There also is a graphical log viewer in Linux Mint. Open the menu and under System, find Logs. Here you can visually search for fprintd messages. Another alternative is the GNOME system log, which by default is not installed on Linux Mint. You can install it by typing from a terminal window sudo apt install gnome-system-log, or easier via the software manager, as you can see on screen now. It will appear in the menu structure as system log under the system category. With all of this information, you should be able to troubleshoot your fingerprint scanning issues in great detail, and you can start searching for a solution. Don't forget to disable the debug mode in the configuration files if you went for debug method 2 or 3, and restart fprintd. That's it. Hope it helped, and if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time, bye!